Hello friends, in this session we will talk about yet another application of special equations. We are going to look at a to the power n minus b to the power n is equal to some constant c. Let's take an example. We have x square minus y square is equal to 120. If x square minus y square is equal to 120, then how many positive integral solutions will be there? In this case, let us say we are looking at two sub questions. Number one, x and y are positive integers, and case two, x and y are integers. So, in both the cases, what will be the answer? In order to approach this question, x square minus y square equals to 120, what we will do is, we can say if x square minus y equals to 120, x minus y into x plus y is equal to 120. If x minus y into x plus y is 120, 120 can be written as 120 into 1. This can be written as 60 into 2. This can be written as 40 into 3. This can be written as 30 into 4. This can be written as 24 into 5. This can be written as 6 into 20. Can be written as 8 into 15. Can be written as 10 into 12. Now, if x minus y into x plus y is equal to 120 into 1. From here, can I say x plus y is equal to 120 and x minus y is equal to 1? This will give me the values of x and y that will satisfy my condition. This should. However, there is a catch. And the same thing we will try with all other combinations also. In each of the cases, x plus y is equal to the larger number, x minus y is equal to the smaller number. X plus y is equal to the larger number, x minus y is equal to the smaller number. X plus y is the larger number, x minus y is the smaller number, and so on and so forth. However, there is just one more catch in this that you need to keep in mind. If I say x plus y is equal to 120 and x minus y is equal to 1, if I add these, I will get x is equal to 121 upon 2. Now, because x and y, they both have to be positive integers, 121 upon 2, 60.5 is not an integer. So, this condition will not satisfy. The reason why I am getting this kind of solution is because here, the parity of these two is not same. If they were even plus even would have been even. If they both were odd, odd, odd plus odd would have been even. So, the only thing that you need to add over here is that whenever I represent this number as a product of two numbers, they both should have the same parity. So, they both should be even, even, or they both should be odd, odd. In case we have even, even or odd, odd combination, then we just count those cases and that becomes our answer. So, from here, the cases that would be acceptable would be 121 into 1, even, odd, not acceptable, even, even will do, even, odd, not doable, 34 is acceptable, 24, 5, not acceptable, 26 is good, 15, 8, not acceptable, 12, 10 is good. So, I will remove these cases. So, these are the four cases that will satisfy the condition. They will give me the values of x and y that will give our answer. So, naturally in each of the cases, x and y would be positive integers. So, if x and y are positive integers, how many combinations are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 is my answer. The second part of the question, when it asks x and y are integers. If x and y are integers, they can be positive, they can be negative also. If they can be positive, they can be negative also. Can I reasonably say that whatever value of x I get, whatever value of y I get, it can be positive, negative? This also can be positive, negative? So, that would mean that for each combination of x and y, I will get four combinations. So, positive negative x, positive negative y. So, for each of the cases, I will get four combinations. And if I get four combinations, this will become 4 into 4, 16 answers overall. In general, if I get n solutions from here, 4n will be the answer. If x and y are simply integers, it has not been specified that they are positive integers. So, that becomes the answer for this question.